Hello friends, welcome to NEET window. We have been doing oscillations and we have done 5 videos on oscillation. This is going to be the 6th video. So by this time you are familiar with the equation of simple harmonic motion, the nature of motion, etc. Now I just want you to connect uniform circular motion with the simple harmonic motion. Now circular motion can be represented like this. Say there is this xy plane, x axis, y axis. A particle is going either in the anti-clockwise direction or in the clockwise direction with a constant speed. That is called uniform circular motion, constant speed. Now a particle can go about a mean position, calling it as x equal to 0, then it can go to plus a and minus a. This motion is called simple harmonic motion under certain conditions. Fine. Now let us say this particle is going in a circle with radius is a, with radius a. So I'm talking about two different types of motion. One is uniform circular motion, another is simple harmonic motion. Is there any relation between these two? Uniform circular motion can be either in the anti-clockwise direction or in the clockwise direction. Simple harmonic motion, it can be to and fro motion. So we are going to connect these two. Okay. Now mathematically we know the motion of this particle, the position x, can be written as x equal to a sin omega t plus phi. We have discussed this in sufficient details. And in the case of circular motion, we don't generally use any such mathematical equations, but if it is happening in an xy plane with the center at the origin, definitely you know this can be written as x square plus y square equal to c the radius a square. This is the equation for uniform circular motion, provided center is at the origin. And center can be anywhere else, but the equation will change. But this is for the center origin. This is simple harmonic motion. Fine. Sometimes simple harmonic motion can be written in cos function also. That is another thing. Now, we are going to find out the relation between these two. Okay. Let us start. Consider a particle going in a circular path, x axis, y axis. For convenience, only for convenience, we are taking the center at the origin and the axes are x and y. Consider that a particle was here. This is at t equal to 0. Particle was there, that is t equal to 0. Now draw the radius. The radius has got a magnitude a. Okay. Now in mathematics, angles are generally measured from the positive x axis, then in the anti-clockwise direction, like this. Those angles are positive angles. If you measure it in the opposite direction, clockwise, angles are negative. Register it from positive x axis, anti-clockwise, positive angle, from positive x-axis, clockwise, negative angle. So I can say initially there was an angle here. At t equal to 0, particle was here. Initially that position, the radius is making an angle. Let us call this angle as phi. That gives you the initial position. We call it as initial phase angle, the phase constant. Okay. Now let us assume that this particle has got an angular speed omega. It has got an angular speed omega. We know what angular speed is. Suppose that this particle after some time reaches this point here. Then the radius will change its position from here to here. That means this will create another angle here, the new angle. And the new angle will be more than the initial angle. See, we know if angular speed is omega, then the angle created, we know the basic definition of angular displacement is omega into t, provided omega is a constant, just like s equal to velocity into time. Fine. So this will create an additional angle. So the total angle from here to here will give you omega t plus phi. That is the total angle. I'll repeat everything again. Particle was here initially at t equal to 0. After a time t, it reaches here. Initially, there was an angle phi, which is measured from positive x-axis, which is a positive angle. Little later, due to its angular velocity, it created a little more angle, and that angle is omega t. So from here to here, omega t, initial was phi, so the total angle is omega t plus phi. Now this particle will keep on moving like this, and you can see that angle will keep changing. It will change from phi to omega t plus phi, and this omega, as t increases, the angle can increase. It can keep going on and going on like this. Fine. Now what we are going to do is, we know it's an xy coordinate system. In the xy coordinate system, every point should have its x coordinate as well as its y coordinate. So this point has got x coordinate and y coordinate, and we are going to find out x coordinate and y coordinate. Lot of mathematics, right? What to do? Physics is like that. Okay. Now, see, if I actually tell you the physical part of it, it's interesting, not boring, but this may bore you a bit. Sorry for that. There is no other way, because you're preparing for an entrance examination or a board examination. Naturally, we have to do this mathematically. Practically, this is very simple, very beautiful also. Now, how to find the x coordinate? You drop a perpendicular from here to down here up to this point. You drop a perpendicular. So for doing the further thing, I'm going to erase these initial things. I just want only that angle. Okay. Now you drop a perpendicular from here to here. You know this angle is omega t plus phi. You drop a perpendicular here, then you drop a perpendicular here. The meaning is simple. This distance will give you the value of x, and this distance will give you the value of y. So I'll mark x here and y here. It should be clear. The x coordinate is the distance from the y axis, and the y coordinate is the distance from the x axis. This should be clear. Fine. Now let me call this point as O, this point as P, this point as Q, this point as R. O, P, Q, R. Now we are doing mathematics. What to do? First of all, take the triangle OPR. OPR. Triangle OPR. In the triangle OPR, if you divide OP by OR, OP by OR, OP divided by OR, you will get a cos theta, right? This is adjacent side, this is hypotenuse, it should give you cos theta, cos of the angle omega t plus phi. Cos of the angle omega t plus phi. From that we will get OP equal to OR cos omega t plus phi. What is OP? OP is equal to x, and what is OR? It is a radius A. That is A cos omega t plus phi. Now look at this equation. What is that? It represents simple harmonic motion equation. X equal to A cos omega t plus phi. Fine. Similarly, take the triangle OQR. Take the triangle OQR. In the triangle OQR, we must know that this angle should be equal to omega t plus phi. That must be equal to omega t plus phi. So in that triangle, if I divide OQ by OR, what will I get? OQ by OR, watch carefully, this angle is omega t plus phi, so is this angle is omega t plus phi. For this angle, OQ is the opposite side and OR is the hypotenuse. So this should be giving you sine of omega t plus phi. Proceeding like previous, we will find out that OQ is equal to OR sine of omega t plus phi. Substituting, OQ is equal to Y equal to OR is A, then we will get sine of omega t plus phi. So what is this? This is again simple harmonic motion. Okay, so both x coordinate and y coordinate vary symbol harmonically. Okay, x coordinate varies symbol harmonically, y coordinate varies symbol harmonically. So in mathematics we say that OP is a projection of OR on the x axis. OP is the projection of OR on the x axis and OQ is the projection of OR along the y axis. So we can say like this, x is the horizontal or the x axis projection, y is the vertical or the y axis projection of what? Of uniform circular motion. So we can state like this, what is that statement? Projection of UCM. What is UCM? Uniform circular motion. Projection of UCM, where are we projecting it? We are projecting along x axis, which is a diameter, or y axis, which is a diameter. Projection of UCM along a diameter, any diameter. For convenience, I took x and y. You can take any axis and try. Along diameter is SHM. This statement is important. Projection of UCM along any diameter is symbol harmonic motion. So what is the relation between symbol harmonic motion and uniform circular motion? We did it. What is that relation? The relation is the projection of uniform circular motion along diameter is symbol harmonic motion. How to mathematically derive this? You have to consider a particle in UCM, then make triangles like this. Simply try to find out cos theta and sin theta, then you will get this equation. X is A cos omega t plus phi, Y is A sin omega t plus phi. Fine. Now the practical side of it. Now what we derived mathematically can be understood in physical context. Just try to boost up your imagination power. You need a lot of imagination power in physics class. You know that. Okay, assume that there is a wall here. This is a wall and this is a floor. Consider in it, this is all imagination. Okay, so you have your floor here, you have your wall here, and I'm assuming there is some body, some particle is doing simple harm. Sorry, some particle is going to be in circular motion in air. Okay, you can see in air it is doing like this. Fine. Now, when the particle, say the particle was somewhere here, particle anywhere, no problem. Let us say the particle was here and this is going in the anticlockwise direction like this. I'll mark the direction like this, anticlockwise. Imagine that there is a powerful light coming from this side, a very strong light coming from that side, which will make a shadow of this particle on the wall. So you'll see, exactly here there'll be a shadow. At the same time, imagine another powerful light source coming from the top. This will produce a shadow here. So particle is going in circular path in a vertical plane. This is a wall, this is a floor, light coming. This light will produce a shadow here, this light will produce a shadow here. Now you are ready to understand the relation between symbol harmonic motion and uniform circular motion. Allow the particle to move. Think what will happen to the shadow. That's enough. the particle will go, say it goes from here to here, it goes to the top point, then what will happen to this shadow? This shadow should reach here, from here to there. So the shadow has moved from here to the top. What about the other shadow? The shadow was here, and that shadow has to move to this side. So this shadow will move in this direction, this will go upward. Fine. So you should understand that they are not in the same phase. One is here going to the center, another is in the center going to the center. Now the particle, so I'll just mark this as the position 1. At position 1, shadow 1 was here, shadow 1 was here. At position 2, shadow is here, this shadow is here. Then this will come here, this is position 3. And the shadow will return back here. So here you can see 1 and 3. And what about this thing? One, the third shadow for this one will be here, 1, 2, 3. Then the particle go down here, this is fourth position, and you can see this shadow will move up to here, this is a fourth shadow, but this fourth shadow will be exactly here, so I'll mark 4 here. Then the particle returns here, that I can call as the fifth position, and the fifth position the shadow will come here, 5, but in the fifth position this shadow will go here, that is the fifth position. And these numbers are to compare, okay. So when the particle go up like this, what happened to the shadow? At 1 it was here, at 2 it's here, at 3 it's here, at 4 it's here, at 5 it's here. So this shadow started from here, went up to that point, then came up to this point, then started moving up and down. And this up and down motion is nothing but symbol of harmonic motion. Then, what about this? It started from one side, then went to this side, go to that side like this. So these motions are symbol harmonic, but are they happening in the same phase? They would have been in the same phase if they started at the extreme point and moved like this, but they are not in the same phase. They have a phase difference. One started at the extreme, another started at the mean position. So definitely one of them can be represented as a sine omega t function, whereas the other would be cos omega t function, having a phase difference of 90 degree or pi by 2 radian. So simple harmonic motion, uniform circular motion is two simple harmonic motions with the phase difference of pi by 2. Think about the shadow. One shadow jumping up and down, another going forward and backward on the floor. This is what we proved earlier in that derivation. Okay. Now, let us go back to those equations again. There is some more mathematical thing in that. What is that? We now know that this circular motion has got an x equation which was equal to x cos of omega t plus 5, and we had a y equation for that one, and that y was equal to a sine of omega t plus 5. Just try squaring and adding, square and add, x square plus y square equal to a square cos square theta plus a square sine square theta will give you a square. And what is this? This is the equation of a circle centered at the origin. So mathematically everything is correct. So the conclusion is, every uniform circular motion can be split into two simple harmonic motion which are perpendicular to each other. One will be the sine format, another will be the cos format. So they have a phase difference of pi by 2. Okay. So the projection of uniform circular motion along a diameter is simple harmonic motion. Every circular motion is a combination of two simple harmonic motion of the same amplitude, but a phase difference of 90 degree, one along x axis, another along y axis. This is again practical. Suppose you hold a pendulum, you swing it forward and backward, it will start oscillating. If you can give a push in this direction, that means you are forcing it to oscillate in this direction also. So you are forcing that in the forward backward direction and in this direction simultaneously. What will happen to the bob? Will it oscillate? I'm repeating, you are giving an oscillation in one direction and trying to oscillate in the perpendicular direction. Then you can try this at home. Take a stone, tie it in a string, try this. Then you'll see that the particle, the stone, will start moving in a circle. So how to produce circular motion? That is by combining two oscillations. Or two oscillations, a circular motion can be considered as two oscillations. See guys, we just studied the relation between uniform circular motion and the symbol harmonic motion. We know uniform circular motion, if you project along a diameter, you get symbol harmonic motion. Now, this is a question, similar questions are there in NCERT textbook, even inside as well as in the exercise part. Okay. Now, this is a little different from that one, basically is the same thing. Alright, in this what is given is that there is an x-axis which is marked in meter, y-axis marked in meter, and there is a particle here at t equal to 0 and the angle is 45 degree. T is given as 4 seconds, T must be the time period, and this point is marked as 2, 0. What is given? Write equation for SHM along x and y axis. Of course, this is a uniform circular motion, the projection must be SHM, we have to write the equation. And for writing the equation, we need omega, and omega can be calculated from the given time period, and we need the amplitude of the oscillation, and amplitude is nothing but the radius here, and the radius is given as 2 meter. Initial angle is given as 45 degree. Let us try how to draw this, how to write this. For this, this is at t equal to 0. You have to allow some more time. Let us say the particle is given an arrow mark here, so that means it's going in the anticlockwise direction. So after some time, the particle will reach somewhere here, and this will be the new radius, and the new angle will be 45 degree. You don't use degrees in your equation, you use it in radian. So this must be converted into pi by 4 radian. And this is the additional angle created due to the motion, and that is going to be omega t. And that omega you can calculate. So let us proceed. Think about the perpendicular here. This is what we call as x. And we know x is nothing but a cos omega t plus phi, the total angle. So I can say, I can directly write x equal to a is the amplitude, and this is the cos function, a cos of omega t plus pi by 4, omega t plus pi by 4. Now what is a? A is nothing but 2 meter, then we write cos of, how to find omega? Omega is 2 pi by the time period, so I can do omega here. Omega, omega, oh my omega, 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 my dear omega, 2 pi by t equal to 2 pi by 4, which is equal to pi by 2. This is my omega, my dear omega. My dear omega is here, pi by 2 into t plus pi by 4. So that is the equation for the symbol harmonic motion along the x-axis. And if you want that along y-axis, y equal to, you can go, that is the standard form, a sine of omega t plus phi, which is equal to 2 amplitude sine omega, omega, my dear omega, this is pi by 2 t plus initial angle is pi by 4. So that becomes simple. This is the equation for the SHM along x-axis. This is the equation for SHM along the y-axis. Okay. We did that. Okay.